Put simply, the development of the clean energy and energy efficiency technologies has the potential to spur one of the greatest economic opportunities of the 21st century. The Obama administration and the United States Department of Commerce have already made unprecedented investments in clean energy, and we're committed to ensuring that American leadership continues in this sector. The Obama administration, under the leadership of President Obama, has invested over $90 billion in clean energy through the Recovery Act, which has spurred $110 billion in additional capital from businesses, universities, and others. And it's passed the toughest fuel standards in history and incentivized more stringent efficiency standards for buildings, appliances, and consumer electronics. Of course, spurring domestic clean energy innovation is only one half of the picture. We're also working to get these two new technologies into foreign markets to help them meet their clean energy challenges. That is one of the many reasons that the Department of Commerce led the development of the Renewable Energy and Energy Efficiency Export Initiative, also known as RE4I, an effort of the eight U.S. government agencies co-chaired by the Department of Commerce and the Department of Energy. Through this very important energy initiative, we're focusing our resources on meeting the exporting needs of the renewable energy and energy efficiency industries. As you know, exports are already a central part of the administration's economic recovery strategy. Last year, President Obama announced his National Export Initiative, or NEI, which aims to double U.S. exports in 5 years in support of millions of American jobs. The RE4I, the Renewable Energy Initiative, will help meet those export goals while turning the lens of the National Export Initiative on the high-growth sector of renewable energy and energy efficiency. In particular, this energy initiative will better tailor U.S. government financing products to the specific needs of the renewable energy and energy efficiency sector. For example, the Overseas Private Investment Corporation, OPIC, will now allow financing for energy efficiency improvements that can be paid back with the cost savings over time. And we're also actively working to reduce or eliminate trade barriers that hinder or prevent trade in this important sector. Make no mistake, the race to get and create clean energy and create jobs is already underway in countries around the world, from China and India to Japan and Germany, and dozens of countries in between. Renewable energy has been called on to lead economic growth and create jobs. But the pursuit of a clean energy future cannot be justification for protectionism. The United States is one of the most open economies in the world, and we continue to work with our trading partners to keep markets open and allow for the free flow of capital and ideas across the borders. We know that on a level playing field, that United States companies and workers are competitive anywhere in the world. Under this renewable energy initiative, we've committed to boost the number of trade promotion events to better link international buyers with the sellers of U.S. technology. So across the supply chain, up and down the supply chain, United States companies can provide products and expertise in almost every renewable energy or energy efficiency industry. At the Department of Commerce, it's our job to help our companies get their products and services in front of potential foreign buyers. United States firms are world leaders in the renewable energy field, and they're eager to work with Caribbean governments and private sectors in developing clean energy projects in this region, which will bring growth and jobs both here and at home. Our foreign commercial services office in Santo Domingo, led by Bob Jones, I'm sure many of you know Bob, is a great resource for companies looking to explore linkages with firms in the energy sector, or any sector for that matter. Our trade specialists welcome your visit, your call, or your email. You can certainly find them on our website, trade.gov. Let me close with this. By mid-century, global energy use is likely going to double. We need this new energy to be clean, to avoid catastrophic climate change. And it has to be cheap to keep our economies growing. That is the challenge, but that is also the opportunity. We look forward to working with you as partners and advocates as you help facilitate the greater use of renewable energy in the region, which would be a win-win for the economy, for the environment, for the people here in this region of the Caribbean and the people of the United States of America. Thank you so much. Thank you.